all the examples where we computed the rank and nullity of a linear transformation, we saw that the rank and nullity add up to the dimension of the domain. Well, for a matrix transformation, this is intuitively clear. The rank equals the number of pivots, the nullity the number of free variables, so the sum equals the number of columns of the matrix, so the dimension of the domain. But why is this true in general? That is what you will learn in this video. So, what's the idea? If you have a transformation T from V to W, linear, dimension of V equals n, smaller than infinity, then the theorem says that indeed the rank of the transformation plus the nullity together give us n, the dimension of the vector space V. In this video we will take a look at the idea of the proof. So, how does it work? Why is this true? And I will fill in the gaps. The precise proof will follow in a later video. So, what's the idea? Well, the kernel is a subspace, so it has a basis. So, the basis of the kernel of T consists of, say, k vectors, v1 up till vk. Now, this is a subspace of V, so you can add vectors to this basis to get the basis of all of V. So, the basis of all of V will be the same vectors v1 up till vk, and then you have to add some vectors vk plus 1 up till vn to get the basis of all of V. Now, what's the idea now? That's illustrated in this figure. This V basically splits up kind of in two parts, h1 and h2. h1 over here consists of all vectors in the null space, so they are all mapped to the zero vector in W over there. And then we have some parts that is left, h2, so the span of all those other vectors, and that part is mapped over here to the yellow part, to the range of T. And now then, there can be still some part that we can't reach in W, that's the red part, but okay. So, V consists of h1 and h2, that's the idea, h1 mapped to the zero vector, and h2 mapped to the range of T. Now, what do we have to show then to really prove the theorem? Well, first of all, we have to show that the span of the T, the image of vk plus 1 up to tvn is indeed the range of T. So, actually that means that you have to prove two things, that T, vk plus 1 and all the others and the span of that are inside the range, and that if you do that, that you also have all of the range. So the range is also contained in the span of those vectors. That's what you still need to prove. And second, you need, of course, to show that T, vk plus 1 up to tvn are independent. If you have that, you are basically done. Because what do you know then? Then you know that the basis of the range of T will be tvk plus 1 up to tvn. So you can compute the dimension then, the rank of T. That's the number of vectors over there. Well, you start at k plus 1 and you end at n. That means that you have n minus k vectors over there, so the rank of T will be n minus k. You know, of course, the nullity, that's because the basis of the kernel over here is the set v1 up to vk, so the nullity of T will be k. And then you see, if you add those two together, you get n minus k plus k equals n. So that's the theorem over here, rank of T plus nullity of T equals the dimension of V. This is the outline of the proof and the idea why it works. Still need to show those two statements over here, of course. We will defer that to the next video.